band is going to be performing the entire Survival album live from the 919 Club. Yeah. And I was fortunate enough to be on the original Survival tour with Bob Marley. I discovered reggae 40 years ago reading an article in Rolling Stone by a gonzo journalist from Australia named Michael Thomas, who wrote, "Reggae music crawls into your bloodstream like some vampire amoeba from the psychic rapids of Upper Niger consciousness." Please welcome the
is intended to be a museum and a research institute because it covers so many different things. It's not just a bunch of records, you know. There's 140 cubic feet of clippings and about 3,000 books and magazines. I've lost count of the t-shirts. It could be anywhere from 1,200 to 1,500 t-shirts and thousands of posters. Many years ago, the Schomburg Institute in New York tried to buy the archive. The official title is the Schomburg Institute for Research in Black Culture of the New York Public Library. One of the main interests for me in the past 20 years is the internationalization of reggae, because that's what's keeping it alive today. There's not a lot of really important stuff coming out of Jamaica anymore, because the whole business has been taken over by the drug lords, and they're not making conscious music.
Well, tonight is about a survival vibe, and it's about a revolutionary vibe. So do you want some more revolutionary Rasta music?
You get the Natty Dread album in 74, where he was really militant, and, you know, 3 o'clock roadblock and revolution and all these songs about fighting fire with fire, essentially. But he eventually came to the realization that the only way you're going to change the world is to change yourself.
Say, won't you bend me down, Lord? Let me tell you where I go. Except it's a right road. You reap what you sow. Now, yes, I tell you.
Hello, guy.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm so glad you were able to come. Thank you.
Oh, yeah, it's great. Let's eat here.
Come on in.
Can we slip in there?
Yeah. Let's get you some breakfast. Roger Mayer invented all the effects pedals for Jimi Hendrix and didn't let anybody else have them until Junior Marvin joined the Wailers and he gave them to him for the Exodus album. Which was almost completely re-recorded after Junior joined the group. Yeah, he's a character, though, isn't he?
Oh, he'd sit and tell me stories about Jimi Hendrix. We have nothing to do. I'd get everything set up.
Yeah. You have a working title for your book?
Well, a working title right now would be Babylon by Bus.
Sure.
Notes from a Passenger.
Perfect.
He did the album Babylon by Bus. It's mostly recorded in Paris. I talked to somebody the other day, and they thought it was recorded in California.
No.
They were sure it was recorded in California. I said, no, Babylon by Bus, even though people think it was recorded all over Europe, it was recorded all in Paris. They never told us that it was being recorded. I set up all the amps, all the microphones and everything.
It's going to break your heart. This is Family Man's trial in High Court in London. And I was brought over to be a witness on his behalf, and they ended up not calling me.
We had personal conversations with Bob about how Bob felt about the music, how he felt about Family Man. Mm. And here's the main thing. This is a story I tell to David Grisman and all the people and the people that are my heroes that want to know a good story. Here's the thing. Gary asked Bob, when you handle your band, you know, like, how do you treat your band or how do you handle them when you write a song and how do you guys... He asked him a question. Here's what Bob said. He said, "Fams is the mountain, and we go climbing." That's all Bob said. Back to that little... He said, "Fams is the mountain, and we just go climbing." He gave all credit to Family Man.
Absolutely.
And that word to Gary there reverberates to this day in our circle of friends. "Fams is the mountain, and we go climbing." I am nothing. We're nothing without Fams. And Fams tuned in the my part of the thing is... While they're out there downstairs eating their curried chicken and all of that stuff, Fams and I are on the stage making sure every single thing works before they work on the stage. Fams missing dinner, he's missing everything, but every single show, he skipped out on the partying, on the stuff, and he made sure it was right. What the deal? And then Fams got us to carry in a five shows into our tour, got to carry in a tape recorder around so that we could criticize things on the bus,
sure,
which stirred up a lot of stuff.
Yeah. But this was one of the greatest miscarriages of justice.
It breaks my heart, and we found out about this 2 months after it was the final, like the Supreme Court
it wouldn't
level
have
made of
any
it.
Difference. The fix was in.
I want to give it up for the man who made it possible for us to be here tonight. Make some noise for the architect behind Bob Marley and the Wailers. The legendary bass player, the king of the reggae bass line, Mr. Aston, Family Man. Well, Vancouver Island, you know that Rastaman vibration is always fun.
There's plenty of things to talk about. Before you leave, I've got some things to give you.
Well, let's do that because we're getting close. We're
going to pop back around. Now that I've got in touch with your manager's number,
yeah.
I can come and see you guys.
Yeah.
If you ever need any help out on the road, give me a buzz and I'll help you set up all the gear and everything.